Hey everybody, welcome to the channel. This is my little vlogging ish episode. We are going to Boise, Idaho for my daughter's wedding. Yeah, I'm old enough to have a daughter who's getting married. She's 22. I was just a child when I had her. And here we go. So we're picking up the third grader boy and we're going to head to LAX, which is the airport in Los Angeles, California. We're going to jump on that plane and we're going to fly our buns up to Boise. So I will record this whole adventure and I'll let you know how it goes. Maybe we'll talk comics. Maybe we'll talk Super 73. Maybe we'll talk movies and music. I don't know what we'll talk, but we'll just, a day in the life. This is it. Let's do it. Made it to LAX. We're now here getting ready to wait for about an hour before our flight to Boise. Pretty packed right now, kind of busy for a Thursday night. This mask is going to be killing me. It's already not on my nose. And this is with glasses, dude, these masks suck, but it is what it is. So see how this goes, everybody. Boise Airport, Boise, Idaho. It is 10:30 here and it's like a ghost town. I don't know how big this airport is. I'm assuming it's pretty small. And considering it's a Thursday at 10:30, it's like sleepy town. Everybody's even Smashburger. I do like Smashburger. I will admit that. I will eat me some Smashburger. Okay, this mask is killing me. I hate this mask so much. Okay, we gotta go find some rental cars and then on to the next step. Find getting our hotel. We are here in the wonderful Hilton, the fancy Hilton in Boise, as I drink my cranberry juice from my continental breakfast. We're here for a wedding tomorrow. My eldest, my firstborn is being married and I'm here to do my part, and it's cold. It's 35 degrees. We don't get 35 degrees weather in Ventura. There's snow on the freaking ground. I need to get my jacket. I'm excited. I started reading some manga on my tablet. Didn't get very far though. Let me tell you, dude, traveling with little kids, not conducive to anything fun. So yeah, we're gonna see how this goes. Keep you guys up to date here. We're here, let's do this. Okay, this video is sponsored by Walmart. Where, what's their, they have a tagline? Like, everything is here, or we got lots of shit, or what's, I don't know what they're, they must have a tagline. You know, we're from Arkansas, something like that. Went to Walmart to get some socks. Super random, but it is what it is. No one wears masks here. Nobody. The only people in that whole freaking store, except for maybe one other person, and I'm not exaggerating, wore a mask other than the employees. Everyone else was unmasked. I wore my mask, but now I feel like a Californian conspiracy theorist because I believe COVID is real and nobody here does. So, I don't know what that's all about. It is beautiful here though. I do like the sky. And the cold is, I don't know, maybe it's not horrible. It's been a while since I've been in the cold. What about you guys? Are you guys in cold weather, some of you folks? You just deal with it, right? It's just part of life. Okay, so let's get this done. Let's get some nice socks on us. And let's see what else the day brings us. One of life's great moments. Hotel room, no kids, wife in the shower, just chilling. And I'm gonna read a little bit with my little iPad here, which I really do enjoy. And I'm gonna just go chill out for a little bit. So probably the best moment, these little moments, you know, we're just like, everything's right in the world. I'm chilling out, I got no kids. It always turns out to be about the kids, doesn't it?
Dude, I've read this already like actually one time fully. This is my second read through, and I'm so excited because I love this story so dang much. It is wedding day. We are getting gussied up. We're getting ready. There's one of our flower girls. She's looking good. The boy's getting ready. Mama's getting ready. And we're about to go hit this hard. Salazar style. Firstborn, getting married. Boise, Idaho. We're doing this.
End of the wedding, just you two are gonna come with me to come back to the temple.
Oh, you guys look so.
It is cold. It is snow on the ground. I go now to the wedding. We are gussied up and we're ready to do this.
Yeah, thank you for
inviting me. Sure. Yeah,
otherwise it never happened.
Exactly.
That's right. I'm not really horrible about taking photos. You're good at that.
I'm okay.
My wife's
I'm learning.
Okay.
Hello, everybody. Hello.
Hey.
Hey. We're ready.
It's funny because the temple there is
right. Hello.
Cute kids. Everybody here.
I guess.
Okay,
but
how do I act?
Did you just get one in the restaurant?
Did you
leave
your sister
in the hotel?
No,
sure.
You want
me
to do that right now?
Or?
Oh, gosh, I like
you. Here they go.
Bellissima!
You're the battle.
Yeah.
Okay. She looks stunning!
No, you stay there for 10 minutes.
Hey, go up. Yeah, go up, Karen. Yeah, go get hugs. How wonderful is this? Doesn't matter.
Take it, maybe.
Talk to your photographer. Talk to you guys. Talk to your.
Maggie will tell us.
Okay, I'm
good.
Hey, seems like we're going.
We're
good.
We
got the behind the scenes footage.
BTS footage. I mean, you're cute, little bird, though, but maybe not that cute. That's my dad.
Should we start with like a big group photo and then work your way down? That way people
can leave. Yeah.
Oh, this is a good spot right here.
Yeah, I think that is. Yeah.
Families with kids and then groomsmen and bridesmaids. They have to suffer the most.
So what's the
show?
You
want to go
Oh my gosh.
Come on, turn it around.
Oh, that's a beautiful picture of you.
Maggie, I'm liking this Maggie girl. What a sweetheart.
Well, we got to get Dad in there. I mean, seriously. Dad is giving away baby Bella. I mean, baby. Oh, love it.
It's my little angel.
Oh, there's my gem.
My gem.
And I love you so. People ask me how I've lived till now. I tell them I don't know. I guess they understand. I'm lonely.
lonely life has been. Could life begin again? The day you took my hand. And yes, I know how lonely life can be. The shadows follow me.
In a beautiful temple, a few miles from here, this lovely couple, accompanied by their parents and many others, followed their covenant path, and at the direction and guidance of their Father in heaven, who is as real as we are, who watches down upon us in this very moment, chose to kneel at the altar, to take each other by the hand, and to make eternal commitments. I must tell you that I've been to a lot of weddings in my life, a lot of ceilings in my life. I have never seen a room more beautiful than where the two of you knelt today and made those covenants, not even just with each other, but with each other and your Father in heaven. As long as you continue to include Him in your relationship, in the way you think, in the way you act, in the way you love, you will be blessed. These two have chosen tonight to say additional nuptials to one another, and we're going to give them that honor now. Mm-hmm.
After 7 months of dating, I called my dad with some heavy questions. How do I know if she's the one, I asked. Give it time and make sure you're able to enjoy yourselves, he responded. We dated through all four seasons before I fully knew you were the one for me. I'm glad we waited, but I'm glad the time has finally come. In you, I wanted a friend. I wanted a role model, and I wanted someone to believe in me. Isabella, you're my absolute favorite and best friend. Your example inspires me to be closer to God, to show more love for others, and to be more okay with being myself. I feel uplifted when you say you believe in me, and I want to live up to the person that you see in me. After a year, 3 months, and 21 days of dating, you're still the one that I want. I'm beyond grateful that I could have the honor of being your husband and a part of your family.
When we met on our missions almost 3 years ago to the day, I had no idea we would end up here, but I'm so happy we have. You have a beautiful mind, and I love your passion for life. Your example has taught me more about serving others, living an excellent life, and charity. You inspire me to be a better disciple of Christ. I feel so accepted by you and so safe with you. You've helped me to fall in love with myself, and I think that's how love is supposed to be. Thank you for choosing me to be your wife.
Well, Ricardo and Isabella, that's about as precious and about as sweet as it can be. My wife and I recently returned from a mission in southern Germany, Austria, and Switzerland. And I can just tell you that Heavenly Father is more and more bringing these missionaries together. This guy was once his own leader. Wow! And then they find one another in love.
Forever. We lost our mic.
The last word was forever. We'll see if this comes back on, and otherwise we'll go ahead with that. I think we're missing
place status.
I understand that the two of you brought rings and you're anxious to put them on. Do we have a ring bearer? Yes. Actually, before you do that,
Ooh. Do
you see it, how beautiful it is? It is without beginning. It is without beginning and without end. This is the beginning of an incredible journey. Let's see, who's going to do it first?
Santiago.
Okay, Santiago.
Santiago, you can move this side. Good boy.
Just so all of you know, this is truly the ring ceremony. This morning at the temple, they chose not to exchange rings so that they could do it with you tonight. I hope that makes you feel special. I hope that makes you feel loved, because that's what the two of them want and have expressed. They want everyone to know tonight who came here, who took time out of their lives to participate, that you are loved and now part of their family as they exchange these rings. That will be a symbol of their forever love and commitment to one another. Well, we come to a special spot. The two of you have made this commitment, and it is forever. But it often starts with something called a kiss. Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to invite Mr. and Mrs. Sosa to have a special kiss now. And yes, you can cheer. answer? One more. And something that you will learn on a long, cold winter's night is hugs are really wonderful. I could almost tell a story right now, but I better not. I came home from a high council meeting one night, and it was snowing outside.
No.
Shh, Sister Blanchard. And it was snowing outside, and by the time I got inside, I was completely frozen. It was one of the best nights of my life. She was so warm. I hope you two have many cold and warm nights. God bless you. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Sosa. Excuse our wedding party because these young men eventually are going to help us move some chairs. But we're going to invite the Sosas to be here, and we're going to invite all of you to come up and to greet them so that they get to shake every hand and hug every person that's here tonight. So if their parents want to come up and join them on both sides, we will turn this into a reception line for a season of time. Okay? And we'll be back with more information pretty soon. This is going to be a long, beautiful night with a lot of celebration. Eventually a lot of dancing and carrying on. And so we look forward to that moment. So at this moment, if we'll start the music again, we'll invite these two to be here for you to greet. Okay?
They have gluten-free cake. That lemon is so good. Oh, I can't. I just had that.
Really skinny piece?
No, it's chocolate. And raspberry.
Oh my goodness.
And the
red velvet.
Saved it.
Oh,
Show's over. We had a wonderful time. My daughter's married, and now that's it. We go home. It was wonderful. It was wonderful.
It just hit start.
You got it? Well, wedding's over. It's Sunday morning. We're pumping. We're doing some pumps. We're doing some pumps right now. We're doing a little bit of exercise pumps before we get going. I'm pumping the iron, pumping it hard, hitting it hard. we're going to go. We're going to go see the bride and the groom one more time for lunch and then hit the airport. And that's it, guys. So let's see what happens next. Here, we do this. Right, there you go, left, there you go, down, there you go, left, down. Right, down, left, down. Whoa, 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 whoa.
I tried it.
Don't let it see, just do it right now. You get right there. Okay, we are here at Boise. Oh my gosh, I look like the devil. I don't even care, you guys. It's at that point where we're just like trying to get home. And I don't care if I look like Jake the Snake's younger brother or older brother. We're doing this. We're at Boise Airport. We're going to LAX in about an hour. And wonderful trip. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful wedding. Wonderful to see everybody. It was great. It's freaking awesome. And I have been reading some Lone Wolf and Cub, so that's been a lot of fun. I'm enjoying that. And working on my katagana, so working on that. We did find this little arcade shop in Napa, which is next to Boise, and a really cool little indie arcade place. Had some really neat imported Japanese games, which I thought was really neat, so I wouldn't come all the way back for that, but it was really, really cool. There you have it. Back in LA, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Los Angeles. We're back. The familia is behind me. It's about 7 p.m. on Sunday. And it's great to be in LA, man. I love LA. Come on. Come on. This is the best. City of Angels. Here we are. We're going back home. Whoa. Now this is called traveling. It's a lot of people. These people are going to Spokane, Washington. Yeah, dude. It is like 8 times as busy as it was in Boise, man. It is packed. No joke. It's like, it is busy, man. Woo! There's like no seat available. I really want Jersey Mike's.